Press the bell icon on the YouTube app and never miss another update.
That note, I say, ki holo, Mautik sir, we want you on stage. We were waiting for you. We hope your panelists are also ready. Yeah, and we're ready to go. Mautik sir, let's have you on stage. To join Mautik ji on stage, we call upon Ajay Balwankar, business head, Sony Marathi and Sony Pictures Networks India, somebody who has stopped aging 10 years back. Shirish Patanshetty, partner, Fakht Marathi, and advisory board for Dangal Bhojpuri Cinema Entertain and Entertain Bangla. Puneet Dharamsi, VP, Marketing and Investor Education, AMFI. Rabindra Narayan, MD and President, G-Next Media Private Limited. Manish and Viraf, you all should stop looking pretty and go backstage and let them do the talking.
I just feel that I think that this session of all the sessions is going to be a lot more relevant for the coming year, because India itself presents a very unique market today. I mean, we have television, which is increasing at a rate of about 10%. We also have an OTT boom, which is happening. And regional is at the middle of it all. I mean, I'm sure a lot of you are familiar with the BCG reports that have come out, which shows that 45% of all Indians' regional consumption on OTT comes through regional content. And 40% of the people want to watch their favorite content in regional. So it's an interesting market. And you know, the idea is to today get into the nuances of it, since we have, you know, the best panel that we could have asked for over here. So what we have here are all disruptors in their own regional spaces, and I'm sure they'll be sharing a lot of interesting insights today to do with the same. Just to start with, I mean, when we started the discussion here, the first thing that came into mind was, what exactly is regional? Why do we even call this content regional? There's a certain way that we bucketize it, which probably is not the right way of looking at it, and we probably need to put in a different lens to, you know, look at this whole content phenomena that is going on. So I just wanted to ask you, Ajay, in terms of your views on what exactly does, you know, you would think about it.
So Mautik, one thing which I have always believed is, when you are dealing in any GEC space and you are talking in certain, or you're creating content in certain language, it is GEC at the end of the day. The kind of yardsticks that you'll put in terms of content creation, impact, etc., are going to be from the GEC spectrum. You're creating content in Hindi, you're creating content in Marathi. Yeah, so that's just a language difference that one is talking about. Because I think somewhere gone are the days when we are talking about putting certain set-top boxes in certain boxes in certain cable households in a particular geolocated kind of an environment. Today, content is consumed across the country and across the globe. So, you know, any language, we ourselves consume today content in multiple of languages. It's not that we are just restricting ourselves to our own mother tongue, or we see dubbed content, we see subtitled content, we see all kind of content. So what do you mean by regional is a big question, and it's something that I don't really agree with, that, you know, if I'm running Sony Marathi, it's a GEC channel in Marathi language. That's how I'd like to put it.
Shirish, you are running, for me, one of the fastest growing regional entertainment network today. And you were talking about some very interesting insights about, you know, how that came into being, and, you know, how you were looking at this whole piece. Do you want to just share those things with the audience?
Yeah, so as a network, we have a network of 5 channels today, where Dangal being a Hindi GEC, which we migrated from Bhojpuri in early 2017. Then we have Bhojpuri Cinema, which is in the Bhojpuri segment. We have Fakht Marathi. We have Entertain, which is a movie channel. And then we are launching Entertain Bangla, which is a Bangla GEC channel. Coming to this entire space of regional as a category, and with the content understanding that Mr. Manish Singhal has, it's a mix and variety of the regional channels that he's taken step to. While we are talking on regionals, there's a lot of coverage which says that a lot of migrant population which comes into is also getting acquainted to the regional space channel that, or the language that they are into, where there's a lot of regional consumption being acquired by the migrants as well. So a latest report which came in 2018 said that the Marathi consumption in the migrants has gone double in the last decade.
So just to, you know, if you want to share a little bit about how Dangal is doing and, you know, how it is giving a run to the GEC space today and how you've been able to, you know, do that transition from being regional to digital, because that for me is a great case study.
Yeah, so with Dangal, while we moved from the Bhojpuri segment to the Hindi GEC space, and with the content that we have, the shows like Shani and Ramayan, Dangal is now in the top 10 bracket fighting against the biggest, while the company that we are is neither an MNC or is a corporate culture. So coming from the space, the content understanding is very important for people to be fed with. The TSV that we have on Dangal is close to about 38 minutes plus.
Thanks. Puneet, from an advertiser perspective, because Puneet is one of the you know, biggest advertisers when it comes to regional channels, what are your views with the whole bucketization of regional? Is that an excuse to pay less money to them?
Yeah, so like I was telling you, for us in regionals, the ad volumes over the last few years have gone up by 40 to 50%. But thankfully for us, rates have gone up only by 10 or 20%.
Thankfully. So
okay.
So as an advertiser, I'll be very happy with that, and I would hope that that continues for some more time. But yes, for us, all languages are important. Since we run a awareness campaign trying to get every Indian to invest in mutual funds, for us, each and every language is important. So there, we find out that consumption in regional languages, as we call it, has gone up a lot. We ourselves work in 7 different languages. All our digital videos we create in 7 different languages. Our website is in English, Hindi, Tamil. We are trying to go do more regional languages. So for us as an advertiser, regional is equally important as any other language.
So would you have any effectiveness study in terms of regional versus, say,
yes, so on our website, if I talk about our website, because that's the immediate measurable, we've seen that time spent on the Hindi and Hindi website is almost double the time spent on the English website. Because there is not much content available on the category, plus people want to consume more content. We are advertising across the country, tier 1, tier 2. And from tier 2, we are seeing a lot more time spent and a lot more consumption of our videos happening. Okay.
Rabindra sir heads is the MD and president of GeneX Media, which runs the PTC networks. So he has very strong views when it comes to regional content. He feels it should be called international content because that's the space he comes from.
See, my take on regional in terms of Punjabis is very simple. Punjabi or Alu duniya ke har kone mein milte. So for me, there is no region. We're not producing Punjabi content for Punjab only. We are the only Indian company which produces content for Punjabis worldwide. Our biggest audience outside India is in Canada. And there is no other company which has 2 studios in Canada, one in Toronto, one in Vancouver, 2 studios in USA, one in New York, another in Fresno, then in London. And we've recently started beaming 6 channels in UAE. So in US, we have 7 Punjabi channels. Overall, if you see, we have 17 different beams of our 7 channels going to different corners of the world. So where are we regional? We're not. Regional, we are only when we go to the advertiser. That's how they flog you. Punjabi, yeah, you are only for Punjab. You'll get only this much rate. But in terms of content, I'll say the best of the innovations in content is happening in regional content. Be it Marathi, be it Gujarati, be it Bhojpuri or Punjabi. All innovations in programming on television is happening there. And
so in terms of your network portfolio, you were saying the number of channels that you had, which was quite mind-boggling. Would you want to share that?
Yes. See, we already had for the last 10 years running 3 Punjabi channels. One was PDC Punjabi, which was a GEC channel. Then we had PDC News, which was a news and current affairs channel. And PDC Chakde, which was a music channel. Now we're launching in February PDC Punjabi Gold, which is a movies and sports channel, Punjabi. Then PTC Simran, which is 24/7 Sikhism-devoted channel. And we are the only company in the world which has a 24/7 streaming channel on Facebook called PTC Dole TV. There is no other channel which is running 24 hours on Facebook. We were the first ones to launch. So a lot of innovations, as I said, are happening in content which is regional.
No, which is great, which kind of brings me to the, you know, the next point of discussion, which is to do with content innovation. And Ajay, you've worn different hats. You were the person who set up, you know, one of the founding members of Zee Marathi, and then you've gone on to head Hindi GECs, and you know, this is your next innings in the regional space. How do you compare the content innovation that is happening, say, in the Hindi GEC space versus the regional space right now?
In simple lines, if I have to say, when you're creating content for Hindi, you don't get as much freedom in terms of, because you're talking to Rajasthan, you're talking about Maharashtra, you're talking to Uttar Pradesh, you're talking to Bihar, Delhi, across the country, and that, you know, then you're trying to get a lowest common denominator for all these regions, their sensibilities. So that's one thing, when you do one language specific channel, then you can be much more, you know, homogeneous as a creator. That's one part. The other, beyond homogeneity, it's also what I see is authenticity. You know, when you are creating content for say a specific socio-cultural kind of a set of audiences, then you can go into details, which on a, you know, Hindi GC, since you are catering to such a vast variety of people, that somewhere gets missed out. So the experience that you have is much more intimate, you know. So all of us sitting out here, when we talk in our own mother tongue, the kind of the intimacy that you experience is different than what you will otherwise do. So that provides you a lot of freedom, is what I think. You know, when Ravinder just said that, you know, there are a lot of innovations happen. Be it, you know, Marathi GCs, be it in Southern or Bengal, you know, or in Punjabi.
Any specific innovations that you want to, which Sony Marathi has done in the last 8 months?
See, when, we're 5 months old on 19th. So, in this 5 months, we have a show which, in GC, Hindi GC, you cannot imagine creating a very studied kind of a show which talks about history of a particular area. So there are lots of historicals happening, but they like when you create historicals on Hindi channels, there's a lot of fiction that you end up creating, you know.
It's a lot of masala.
I've done many, so I can't say that. But the thing is, you're trying to read between two lines, you know. There is A point of war and a B point of win, and what happens in between is all, you know, something that you create. Whereas on Sony Marathi, we have a show called Garza Maharashtra, which talks about right from Jnaneshwar to Ambedkar, story of how Maharashtra as a state evolved. So something like this cannot be imagined on Hindi GCs. Or say, there is one show which we do, which is a regular daily soap. In that, we dealt with a story wherein a girl in the house, it's a family, and in that family, there's one girl who is 12, 13 year olds, her menstrual cycle begins, and there are only men at home. Coincidentally, at that point in time, all the women are out on some other or the other work. Now, it was so sensitively dealt with. So those kind of things, when you do in a specific socio-cultural kind of area, you can do a lot. You can do it with a lot more rigor. You can do it with a lot more authenticity. Okay. So I think that's something that you can...
I would add...
That's the freedom that Vinay is talking about.
Shirish, in terms of the content innovation that, you know, you guys are bringing out, you were talking about mythologicals and you were talking about a very different strategy that you're adopting to take on the mainstream GECs. Would you like to just like take the audience to that?
For us, on the GEC space, what works is the mytho content. Shani is working fantastic for us. Ramayana is working fantastic. So we are creating season 2 for Shani. which will be out soon. On the regional space that we have, most of our channels are movie channels. So what works for us is awards night, events. That's what adds a lot on the regional space, because the nature of the channels is regional. But also what adds up there is a lot of Mytho-oriented content for the morning band, which definitely gets the required eyeballs.
But in terms of way forward, are you exploring other genres, other kind of products?
Yes, for like Entertain Bangla is a clean slate for the GC is what we are looking at. On Dangal, what is also working for us is the crime alert. So the fresh shows that we are looking at on the GC model for Bangla is going to be on Mytho and on others.
Puneet, from a advertiser point of view, is there any specific content that you know you would be more attracted towards? Maybe it may not get you the numbers, but when from a media buying point of view, what is it that you look for?
So, some of the innovation, one of the innovation that I would like to talk here was Star Sports taking sports regional in IPL last year. We were associated with IPL, and that kind of that whole regional commentary of IPL helped us also a lot. Going forward, we've realized that you know just dubbing our content in regional languages is not as effective. So we are seriously considering creating our ads, producing our ads in the regional language with the regional characters. That adds a Ajay said, that adds a lot of authenticity. That gives that whole cultural touch to the ad, and that connects well with people.
Okay. I mean that's a very interesting point, Rabindra sir. You were talking about a lot of innovation, and you were talking about your homegrown formats that you have created over, you know, over the period of time. It, you know, you'd love to educate the audiences about that.
See, almost 12 to 15 IPs that we have created on our own are very unique. For example, nobody is doing singing talent hunt in villages. We started a series called Akhada, where we would go to villages, do auditions, and do the grand finale also in a village. So to get that talent, all the media, whether it is on OTT or television channel, they're all focused on towns, studios. So we want to move out of it. One of our studio shows is Miss PDC Punjabi, which is a beauty and brain talent. And we had auditions of that in Canada. So the girl who won in Canada came to participate here, and she almost won the crown. So a lot of innovation, like there is no other company in the world which is producing an original movie every week. We're doing that in Punjabi.
Which was very interesting. I mean.
Every Friday, 7 p.m., we premiere a film made for television. And that gives us the liberty to tackle subjects which you will not be able to tackle if you have the pressure of the box office or the theater and other paraphernalia. So the stories which we wanted to tell, which are rooted in the everyday life or the heritage of Punjab, we are able to tell that. And there is a captive audience. Suddenly we thought, why should I compete with the Hindi fiction serials, try and produce something like that? Because my audience also watches that. And for Punjabis, Hindi is also their main language. They understand it. So why should I produce content which they're getting in any case on a bigger format and more expensive productions? So we thought we should create all our IPs in a format which is not available to my audience any other way.
And you also have a significant play that you were telling me in terms of festivals and events and other
yes.
things which gets your youth spike.
Yes, that, and we do it worldwide. The Sikh Day Parade in Manhattan, we telecast is live. The Nagar Kirtan in Surrey, we telecast it live. Whenever the Canadian Parliament celebrates Baisakhi or Gurpurab, we broadcast it live to the world. When the Prime Minister of Canada had come here, we were the official channel for them. Even now, we're the only Indian channel which is accredited by the Canadian Parliament, and we cover all their proceedings, all important things. There are 19 Punjabi MPs in Canada. You land in Canada, the signboard welcomes you in Punjabi. Street signs are in Punjabi. So in terms of region, that's what I'm saying. Regional is a term which should not be there. In terms of content, I'll give you another example. We are premiering, producing, creating and premiering two original songs every week. Two songs every week. So we're creating our own content. Instead of the channels being running after music companies to give them license or to give them the software, and then you get it for a limited period of time, and you have to play whatever is available to you. Here, we can create the kind of music that we want to create. The old feel of Punjabi music, which was in the times of Noor Jahan or Iqbal Bano or Nusrat, which is gone in the bottles of vodka and Dunali and all that. So we are bringing that back now.
So Ajay, just one more thing to add to the content piece. I mean, recently we've also been seeing trends to do with more micro-regionalization. So when we look at regional channels, more and more content is actually being made more authentic in terms of specific parts. Like when you talk about content that's coming from Z or even Sony, a lot of protagonists and a lot of settings are very clear. So it's Western Maharashtra or it's Southern Maharashtra, Konkan. So is that a is that actually translating into more audiences? How is that helping?
A couple of things out here. One, I think we should accredit regional channels. They're spreading also content production units across the state. So Jurta 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 Ki is one of our serials, which is completely shot out of Kolhapur. So there is an entire center which is getting developed there. There are series, and coming back to your question, so apart from just the production part of it, when you look at content creation, the authenticity is the big thing, or rootedness as you call it, in all the PPTs on in channels, that rootedness is stems out of this. When you go micro regional, when you get, if you want to talk about a certain issue, we talk about Kolhapur, and Kolhapur means about pailwans and all that. So we're talking about a story which is breaking stereotypes, where this is a short guy who's marrying a tall girl. Okay, regular Delhi soap, agreed. But the way it has been dealt with, the way the authenticity is coming out, it's a lot to do with the way production is also carried out. And that's happened because of our regional channel. So apart from the rootedness part, or apart from the content, so you'll also see a lot of progressive thought that's been dealt with in regional channels compared to, say, national channels, as we if you want to call it like that.
In terms of, like, let's move on to the elephant in the room, which is to do with advertising rates. Obviously it's a chicken and egg situation, because I run a production company and I'm seeing that the regional budgets are increasing, but for you to compete with the look and feel and quality, obviously you will need to get more ad revenues and more subscription revenues to invest in the product. So where does it stand between the chicken and egg? How do you see that panning out?
See, one thing which I want to state out here is, and I want advertisers to also consider this, is I think what is critical is at what mind frame the audiences are watching your ad. If you are watching ad with a hopeful, progressive kind of a environment, and at that point your product is displayed, the likelihood of conversion I think should be higher. And this is with certain researches that were carried also, which was shown that at what mindset. So regional content, Marathi content, if you see, is largely very progressive in nature, very hopeful. And you want to, if you see a product advertised, and that premium has to come in, There is a premium set of, so say, if you consider Maharashtra, it consists about 9% of population in this country, but consumption is about 14% of FMCG. So the kind of richness that a Marathi language channel can bring in terms, so you take it in any kind of, whether it is digital consumption, Marathi consumption is there across the country. Like Delhi, the stack up is Hindi, English, and Marathi. Bangalore, it is the fourth viewed. So it is not just about, and as you rightly said, the ratings are growing, but the advertising rates are not really growing. And I think they'll catch up, and we've always seen that. If you take out even any category, I think they should catch up in next year. It will help me.
Shirish, your views on this?
So the advertising price point on regional channels is not really great as of today. I think a lot of this goes to the weightage given by BARC. BARC is weighting certain markets 21%, but in case of Maharashtra. But if you look at if you exclude Mumbai and Pune, which is a Cosmo, and if you go into the interior parts, yes, it's 100% Marathi consumption. And I believe that in the last 2 years, the GRPs in Marathi have grown from
can
almost
just,
100%.
Sorry, can I just interject? Even in Mumbai, Marathi viewership is the highest.
Yeah, it is there. But yeah, I think the 21% weightage given is taking those required eyeballs where the advertiser feels that his required GRPs is being covered by the Hindi genre itself, which I feel is realistically not correct. Likewise, our one channel, which is Bhojpuri, which is doing 100 plus GRPs, but the research says that it is only 35% television viewing in the entire Bihar market. So if the potential to grow in those markets is much larger than compared to the markets which are today stagnant.
Puneet, your views are very important.
So like Ajay said, I'm sure over the years, pricing will catch up, especially given that now digital is taking content to far corners of the country. So we'll have more and more people wanting to see more content. They will also, I mean, TV's always been an important, will always be an important part. So that flow will happen. Monies will, I'm sure, increase. We are seeing that quality of content, like you said, is progressive. Overall quality of content is impressive in regionals. So slowly but surely, we'll reach there.
Rabindra sir, what are your views? Are you able to, I mean, your views would be very important because you will have local advertisers in different markets and at the same time the national advertiser as well. So how are you able to kind of get more ROIs through that?
See, it's the local advertisers and the entertainment local industry which keeps us going. Otherwise, Punjabi channels, I'll tell you, for years have been victimized. The ratings which used to come used to be combined with Haryana, Himachal, Jammu, Kashmir. It's only 12 weeks ago that BARC woke up and they separated Punjab and Chandigarh from the rest of these Hindi belts. The result was our GRPs more than doubled. So there was more than 100% increase. It's still not the true picture. It'll come out in the times to come. But when I go to the advertiser, they will still treat you as a poor country cousin. Arre, ab to Punjabi ho. Our purpose is served with Hindi. We'll increase one more spot. They don't realize we are putting in more effort, more monies, and more bang into the programming that we are bringing out. And we've got captive eyeballs. My audience actually believes in what we are doing. It actually watches it. Unlike mainline channels, which may get you the numbers based on a larger footprint area, the consumption and the captive consumption of the content may not be more than what is of the regional. A viewer of Marathi language who is a Marathi will be more engrossed in watching what he is watching on a Marathi channel than on a Hindi channel. The numbers may be more.
And that reflects in the TSV,
yeah,
as Ajay
absolutely
was pointing out.
So, which is why the challenge is now to educate the advertisers. Guys, we are putting more effort. We are regional languages, which you say regional. But our viewers are more loyal. They have more money to spend. And they will understand your message in a better manner on our channel. So give us what you, we do a lot of shows. We do big budget shows. We do film awards, music awards, which are our film awards, people say are bigger than film fair. It's 100 by 100 feet stage with all the paraphernalia that you'll show in any of the international events. And it costs you around the same money. But do I get the same advertising? No. I am subsidized by USA, Canada, Europe, and Australia. Those advertisers are chipping in for the loss that I'm incurring here. But it's because of them that I keep doing better and better shows. Whereas the advertisers here must realize these are the guys who are doing new things. These are the guys who need to be supported, encouraged. And frankly, if you see one Hindi channel from the other Hindi channel, you won't be able to tell the difference. That is this show I'm watching on Star or Zee or Sony or Colors or what? You won't be able to. But you see a regional channel, you'll know. Marathi mein dekh raha hu, acha ye to idhar hi milne ka mereko. Ye meri bhasha hai. I know. I identify with it.
Okay. So I think we'll have to conclude very soon. So final last words. It's going to be a complex market ahead with regional GECs, OTTs, and now there are regional OTTs with all the OTTs coming in and investing heavily in regional. What do you see as the market scenario in the coming 2 or 3 years, Ajay?
OTTs are already playing a major role as far as Maharashtra is concerned. Marathi is the third largest consumed language on OTT platforms in India. Today, what content we are creating actually suits places itself well and broadcasting medium as well as on OTT platforms, because the moment you're talking about bit more evolved content, it naturally sits well with OTT players as well. To add to that, Maharashtra has the highest internet connections. It is the number two in mobile connections. So for us, OTT platforms do matter, and for Sony Marathi, they will matter a lot. And you know, we are already creating content which is which can sit well in both the platforms, and that's the journey that we've already started. And thankfully, we are late entrants, so we could do that vis-a-vis other channels.
Shirish,
on the OTT, I believe the largest growing platform for OTTs or the content is Bhojpuri. We have seen about 200% growth year on year, and it is still going very strong. Specifically with the music launch or the movies, they've been close to about 10 million plus views in 24 hours clocking time.
Puneet, you have any last crystal gazing views on the same?
Sure. So OTTs are important for us. We advertise on all on large OTTs. OTTs not only give us viewership, but also give us that whole chance of engagement with the user, with the viewer. So, and going forward, OTTs are going to grow.
Rabindra sir.
See, we are very heavily into digital, I would say, not just OTT. OTT, yes, but digital. So we have 90 Facebook pages catering to different towns, different regions, different markets in the world. Then we have 6 different websites, and we are about to launch an app which would have all the channels besides our VOD content. We also have an audio label, we have a film company. So all of that is available now in digital, which is why we chose to convert all our beams on cloud. So now we have 15 beams going across to different platforms through cloud. So the physical playout is also gone. So we're going completely digital.
So I think the takeaway from all this, and our time's up, is that lines are blurring. Regional is not regional anymore. So I think with that, we conclude the session. Thank you all for listening, and thanks everyone for coming.